Hey, horsey people. Watching Hell on Wheels here, and they've got a another little horsey kind of gets. Now, this show, there's a lot of big bits and a lot of pain. Everyone's got a rifle. These rifles, you notice some rifles are more vertical and some are more horizontal. I find it very uncomfortable to put the rifle under my leg here. One, it pushes against the horse, and it also makes my leg bow out more. So I don't like the rifle under my leg. Some of them will be hanging more vertically right here. You notice this one's a little bit lower. Let's see here. Yeah, most of them pretty much go under the leg stirrup right here. So, but anyway, I just thought it was a good little horsey stand here where these guys go down this hill, and it might be this horse or this one that gives one of the riders an attitude. Remember, when they do these videos, these horses are, I mean, they don't know the script. All they know is they get kicked and hit and things happen, and they're not into, okay, this is going to happen next. A lot of scenes they can't do it three and four times. So the horse gets used to it, so they kind of get let them know what to expect, especially when you have multiple horses and multiple riders. Now you get on a downhill slope, and this one little horse starts kicking. When he starts kicking, the guy kind of starts hitting him. So let's take a look at this. Okay, so the guy says his line, and then they all take off in a line down the hill. So let's take a look at this. Watch the horse on the far right. These two over here. This horse right here. Look at him bucking. He's bucking all the way down that hill. This guy really went slow and lost ground. I'm gonna go back and do that again. These guys are pretty cute.
All the guns in the world will not protect Cullen Bohannon.
Okay, so all the horses are here. And again, these horses, notice the ears back, the pain on the bits. These guys are, I mean, look at this horse. This isn't, I mean, I can't, maybe this horse's ears is kind of forward. Most of the horse's ears are back because they're yelling, ha ha! And they're all moving. And then all the horses start a little bit of competing because you have multiple horses. And this guy comes around far. Notice this guy's hands way out here to the right, way out to the right. They're pulling these horses, wanting a horse to follow his head. The problem is when you use a shank bit, when you do a direct rein like this, it puts more torque this way on a horse's mouth because you're not really pulling him sideways. You're pulling the bit up, which the horse ends up coming because of the pain, but it's not guidance. So let's this horse right here from the jump street kind of starts having an attitude, and this guy starts what I call manhandling, showing who's boss. These guys all turn pretty much and take off pretty good. This guy right here, straight from the jump street's having problems. This horse right here, way head high. Remember, I talk about the only reason you have a tie down is to keep the horse low so you have leverage. This guy's got a pretty good rein. His arm's out straight. He's not yanking. Notice this guy's arm is way back here pulling on a horse. That's where the horse's head is going up. This guy's arm's straight, so he's not yanking on this rein. This rider, reins are tight, pulling in. This guy's kind of leaning forward. Looks like his hands are pretty neutral. This guy looks like he's got a pretty good stance. This guy's hands kind of high, pulling back on the horse's reins. This guy is probably the worst. Notice the head's up and the mouth is open. That's what happens. Those are things that you don't see. And every time I watch a horse movie, it's hard for me not to see this. It's just frustrating. This horse here goes straight back. This guy keeps his hands straight. This guy kind of loses. This horse kind of gets confused a little bit. He's going to turn right. Maybe he doesn't want to go down a hill. I think he ends up being the last horse that we saw at the very end. But this horse right here, man, he is bucking all the way down a hill. And this rider is a pretty good rider because he's down a hill and he kind of just starts kind of whacking him, saying, "Stop your bucking." Remember, when a horse is bucking, he can't buck good when he's moving fast. Most people, when a horse bucks, they tend to pull back on the reins and slow the horse down. If you make a horse go faster, it's harder for him to buck, and if he does buck, it's not usually that big because he's at a full run. So this guy does not want this horse to slow down and start bucking, so he makes sure that he's moving pretty quick. So bucking, tail going up and down, we'll watch this horse, then we'll go back and watch another horse. So keep your eye on this horse right here. Bucking, tail straight up. Bucking, tail straight up. Bucking, bucking, bucking. So most of the horses had room. Notice the one that was kind of bucking, a little trapped, had a horse in front of him. Maybe he was trying to slow down and he was getting hit. The guy wanted him to speed up and he's like, "I can't go any faster. There's a horse in front of me." It's hard to tell what's going on because I'm not right next to him, so I can't see. The last horse that I talked about actually wasn't the last horse. This horse was the last one. I'm not sure which one he was. And I don't know if I can go back. Oh, maybe I can go back with my little arrow.
Oh, Hannon.
Okay, so this guy with the light jacket is not last. I think this guy might be last. But we're going to watch this horse here this time. Okay? This time, this guy was bucking good. Now we're going to watch this guy. So let's keep our eye on horse number two. Head up, hands high, turning him with a shank bit. Almost, I think, loses his balance or slips there a little bit. See how the horse's rear end kind of comes around? And he almost kind of hands way forward. He's trying to neck rein him a little bit and keep that hand forward, but he's got to direct his horse more. These reins really tight, shank bit, really tight, shank bit. Shank bit, horse's mouth is open, his nose is rolling down. Hand way up, head up, pulling hard. Let's see here. Yeah, I think I went too far. I did.
All the guns in the world will not protect Cullen Bohannon.
Okay, so this horse did not want to go down this hill. He wanted to go this way, and he had to redirect him. But he ends up catching up. Probably one of the horses down here end up being last. So this horse is bucking. This horse is number two. This guy's the last horse coming down here. And maybe he's not being aggressive. Maybe he's not kicking as hard. Maybe his horse is older. Maybe he's not as good as Ryder. Maybe he just doesn't want to manhandle his horse. I don't know why he comes in last, but he does come last. He's not first in the comments like some of my commenters. And they ride off into the sunset. I just thought there's so many scenes in Hell on Wheels of horrible, bad horsemanship. The one guy, Ferguson, I think his name is. Man, he's a horrible rider. Every time he gets on a horse, his reins are really tight. His hands really forward. He bounces in the saddle. He says, yeah, yeah, like he's running fast. And the horse is always at a trot. Maybe goes into a little bit of a gallop or canter, but mainly at a trot and he's yelling. But, man, there's some horses get kind of beat up and a lot of things happen to horses in this series. But I like when a little horse, you know, kind of gives a his little bucking fit like this one does right here. He's spunky. I like him. Quit hitting me, dude. Quit pulling on me. I'll buck your butt off. Good little horsey. They're all good horsies. All right. We'll end that there looking at some Hollywood horsey stuff.